I saw the comments of the Prime Minister yesterday, and of course I support the comments of the Prime Minister. So there's been, as I said a couple of weeks ago, when this was first discussed about whether there should be a reduction in the NOM or the net overseas migration number, I said at that time that I supported the number where it was. That's the government position. That's the position I support. And in terms of the Prime Minister's position, my position, there is no difference between us on these issues. Now, I'll add to that, though, because as you'd expect, and as every immigration minister would have, I have canvassed different options around the composition of the program. We have huge surges, for example, in the numbers of international students coming through, which is a great thing for our economy. We have surges in the numbers of visitors coming through, which are both reflected in that normal figure. And we need to talk more about the figures and the impact, the economic benefit of tourism, of those international visitors, all of that that plays in. So yes, of course I look at different options, but the government's taken a decision to set the norm at 190,000. I think it's been that, roughly that, since about 2012. I note that last year it was down from that by about 7,000 to roughly about 183,000. And I haven't, of course, seen final figures for this financial year, which we'll know about over the next couple of months, but I would expect the number to be less than 190,000 this year anyway, which is then treated as an estimates variation.
Okay, so this is the problem. This is the problem, Minister, because what the Prime Minister was asked yesterday quite specifically was, has Mr. Dutton ever canvassed that? Now, he said that is not true, and that is, on your evidence, this press conference today alive.
Sam, that's not the way to interpret it. I saw the Prime Minister's comments yesterday. I've read through what the Prime Minister had to say, and I fully support his comments. There's no point of difference between the Prime Minister and I. I'm not getting into who said, at what meeting, where it was, who was sitting in the meeting and the rest of it. I don't comment. I never have on Cabinet or other gatherings. But as I made the point before, and as you expect, of course the government canvasses what the program number should be. We do that each year. The 18,750, which has come up from 13,750 over the last few years, of course, has been discussed. It's not just something that's arrived at. So whether there's an increase or a decrease or consideration around where those settings should be, that is something that's contemplated from year to year. So I've looked at the comments that the Prime Minister made yesterday, and I support those comments.
In these discussions with the colleagues, did you
Well, again, I'm not going into comments or discussions and who said what and who was in the meetings and the rest of it. Others can speculate on that. I don't, as a policy, I never have in 17 years, commented on what's been discussed in Cabinet or subcommittees or whatever it might be, or gatherings of Cabinet colleagues. But as I say, it's, as Immigration Minister, as Scott Morrison did, as Chris Bowen did, Philip Ruddock, whoever you like to nominate, of course there are discussions that take place around what the figure should be, the benefits of different aspects of migration. There's obviously a debate about congestion and about housing affordability. And the government's alive to all of those concerns, about geographic placement of people, trying to attract people out to the regions. They are all issues to consider. There were big changes that we made in relation to the 457 visa changes that we announced recently. There was obviously a debate within Cabinet, discussions that take place within different gatherings and between colleagues. So,
okay, but I'm not. I'll just finish this.
So I'm not. The point that I'm making is I'm not going into detail of what was said at what meeting on what day. I've seen the comments of the Prime Minister yesterday, and I fully understand.
Okay.